Τώρα την άποψη πως η Τουρκία θα επιδιώξει να εμφανιστεί ως συμβιβαστική δύναμη τους επόμενους μήνες, ώστε να προκαταλάβει τη νέα διοίκηση Biden, αλλά και να αποτρέψει οποιαδήποτε διαδικασία κυρώσεων από την Ευρώπη. Εκφράζει, μιλώντας αποκλειστικά στον Sky και τον Απόστολο Μαγκυριάδη, ο διευθυντής της Αμερικανικής Δεξαμενής Σκέψης American Progress, Max Hoffman. Να δούμε τι είπε.
Max, thank you for being with Sky tonight. Here in Greece, we have a strong interest in getting a sense of how the Biden administration will act towards Turkey. What should we expect?
Well, I think the new Biden team has a pretty clear understanding of who Erdogan is and what his goals are. You know, they see him as essentially an autocrat who is trying to expand Turkey's role in the region and build Turkey into a great power in its own right, and paying much less heed to U.S. interests and the interests of its traditional Western allies. That causes big problems for the U.S. and for NATO, and it has led to a series of disagreements over Russian arms sales and regional issues. That all said, I don't think the Biden administration has any desire to sort of lurch into a very punitive approach towards Turkey. They don't want to go down that escalatory cycle. And in the context of trying to sort of calm down some of these regional conflicts, I think they'll try to manage those tensions and nudge Turkey back towards a more conciliatory approach.
Max, as you know, tensions were high during the summer in the East Med. Erdogan is expressing a maximalistic approach in dominating the maritime zones, and he's ignoring the international law of the sea. If diplomacy doesn't offer any help, how do you think the U.S. will intervene in case of a deadlock?
Well, Erdogan has, as you said, been very aggressive and increasingly militaristic in pushing his regional claims. But I think he's run up against a very delicate sort of tripwire. The Turkish economy is in such rough shape. They're desperate for foreign direct investment, very reliant on hot money that can flow out very quickly. And so I think he's also interested in being in a bit of a conciliatory cycle for two reasons. He wants to influence the incoming Biden team, and he also wants to stave off any European Union unity and a more sort of strong approach towards Turkey. So I think he may be in a bit of a conciliatory cycle for some time, but Erdogan is Erdogan, and the domestic realities of his nationalist support and his long-term ideological goals to redraw these borders will probably win out. So perhaps a calm period and then some escalation later in 2021. And, you know, the Biden team will reinforce NATO Secretary General Stoltenberg's efforts to set up deconfliction mechanisms, and they'll really rely heavily on those diplomatic approaches and hope that coordinating with the EU, they can draw clear red lines and say, you know, if you cross these lines, there'll be serious economic sanctions, because the alternatives are unthinkable.
Do you think Europe will follow the U.S. in imposing sanctions, and are they really effective?
Well, we'll see a bit more in March. Thus far, the European Union has shown itself to be sort of an incoherent foreign policy actor. There are big divisions between member states. I think, you know, France and certainly Greece and Cyprus favor a stronger line. Germany, particularly Chancellor Merkel, have tried to keep channels open with Turkey. I don't see those issues being resolved. And frankly, the conciliatory phase from Erdogan is designed to give the EU whatever excuse they can have to do nothing, because that is certainly the preferred option for Brussels. It's status quo. And part of the reason for that is just a desire to continue economic relations. But the big reason, of course, is management of the refugee question, which Greece is very familiar with. And Erdogan can merely sort of threaten an incident at the border, and many European politicians go running for political cover. So I don't think we'll see a very strong response from the EU unless Erdogan really pushes things too far and there's danger of a military escalation. And then perhaps it will spark serious action. And I just hope that, you know, that is not too late. I think the action should come sooner.
Finally, how do you see the U.S.-Greek relationship evolving, and in what ways do you see Greece being useful for the U.S. interests?
Well, you know, the U.S. would like stable democratic relations with both Greece and Turkey, and it has no desire, I don't think, to sort of choose sides in these maritime and other disputes. But certainly there's been sort of a slow process to hedge U.S. bets and the U.S. posture in the region, and Greece has been a natural partner for many of those things, including energy and military basing access. And so I think that you'll see that sort of slow adjustment continue under Biden. Biden has long familiarity with and affinity for the Hellenic world and Greece and Cyprus. And so that will continue. You know, Biden is not likely to oversee the sudden lurches in U.S. policy that we saw under Trump. So, you know, hopefully continuing deepening of relations and the U.S. perhaps also trying to reclaim the traditional role of fair arbiter in trying to mediate this dispute between two NATO allies who, you know, nobody in Washington certainly would like to see at loggerheads.